What's up, my boys?
Hey.
It's a food tour day today.
One of our favorite videos to do. So you know that it's epic entertainment o'clock.
We are here in Funchal. We have fallen in love with this city, even though we really haven't explored very much. But today it's all about exploring the cuisine of Funchal and also the cuisine of Madeira.
There's like more than 20 things we want to try, so we've handpicked what we think is most interesting.
So the number one suggested food from you guys is actually a Madeirian dessert. It's called bolo de milho. So history about this dessert goes back to the 15th century, where nuns created this cake in Santa Clara here in Madeira Island.
It's very sturdy, like it's almost like a hard piece of bread.
It's a sugarcane honey cake, and it's much more dry than I expected.
And by the way, we got this at a pastelaria here in the old town, which has amazing reviews. So this is not just a gas station bolo de milho. This is a high quality piece of
Here.
It reminds me of Christmas.
In Denmark, you make these as a heart, so you shape them like a heart and cover them in chocolate, and then you give it to people you love during Christmas. Oh, this is so good.
It looks like a human brain on the side. But I guess that the tone has been set. This is gonna be a food mecca, and let's just dive even deeper.
Just what I got to do to be your man, baby. I'll be your little puppy dog. Oh, just tell me when to come, baby. I'm there at your beck and call, baby. There.
This is the first proper food of today.
We are at Otashko, which is a nice restaurant, we hope, we've heard, where that serves typical Madeiran food.
We are having lapas, which is limpets, and they are caught right here in the ocean. The way of eating them is to pour a lot of lemon juice, should I?
Do it.
Here we have the bolo di caco. Bolo di caco is a garlic bread that is roasted in, I think you have to make them right away and then serve them.
Yeah.
It has like butter and garlic and parsley in it. And one of the things that I am most excited about today is the milho frito.
Milho frito. We've heard a lot of good stuff about this. And it has some mushy content.
Yeah, it's fried cornmeal. So this is something that I have never tried before.
What is the last year, Amelia?
So what is special about this dish is that it is roasted or grilled on a laurel stick. That will add a lot of different flavors to the meat that you are not usually getting. And that is something you only find here on Madeira.
I'm gonna start with milho frito. It's super greasy. I think it's been fried in oil. If you looked at it, you would think that it could be raw fat. And it has a fatty taste as well. But it's not disgustingly greasy. What do you think?
It's so odd because it's a cornmeal, but it tastes a bit like a deep fried potato. It's such a strange texture. I never had it before, but it's very addictive.
Next up,
lapas.
Lapas. They are so beautiful.
They are so pretty.
And you have to eat them like an oyster because we poured lemon on top.
And also there's a lot of juices from the panning, from the frying. Ready?
Oh my god. Oh wow, this is good.
One more.
This is amazing. It looks amazing and it tastes amazing.
This is much better than the normal mussels that we have.
A lot of the dishes here that are native to Madeira are becoming popular on the mainland of Portugal. But when you catch this off the coast here in Madeira, it's hard to get it, you know, straight to the mainland. So when you get it in the mainland of Portugal, it's just not the same. I mean, this is probably some of the best Portuguese food I've had so far, like seafood.
Yeah, and it's fun because you can really taste the ocean. Like, it tastes like sea, but not in a disgusting way, in a really delicious way. This is the bolo di caco. It tastes like it's made in a wooden oven, like a pizza would be.
I like it, but I'm not, you know, wow. You are?
It's bread.
Yeah, but then bread is always good, but I don't think this is special. I just think it's good.
Yeah.
I could eat a kilo of this, but it's not spectacular or unique, in my opinion.
But sometimes simple is also perfect.
I feel like these, what's the name again? Milho fritos?
Milho fritos.
I feel like they would be even better if you had something to dip them in.
But that's typically you. You only want shorts with everything.
Espetadas. And this is don't give me that song on the brain.
Sorry.
It's too late.
I'm sorry. Cheers. Let's dig in. So flavorsome.
Very tender.
This piece of meat is just delicious. If this day continues in this, I think I will consider moving here to Madeira.
Which one was your favorite of these?
No doubt.
Yeah?
Yeah. Just because it's so different. I also think that these molho fritos is really, really delicious and different. But I mean, the lapas is by far the number one.
This was a delight to try some of the most typical Madeiran food. There is a substantial difference to the food you get in Portugal in the way it's presented and served. So that was a unique thing to experience. But we're not done yet. It's drink time.
Funchal is one of the things that we have been recommended the most from our subscribers to try here in Madeira. It's an alcoholic drink and it's made with liquor from the sugarcane. So it's the water from the sugarcane that you make into an alcohol and then you make the Funchal with that alcohol. It's very much like an English punch, but it was actually made in Madeira before it was made in England. Most people here in Madeira actually say that this cures flu-like symptoms, which I suffer from today. So I think I should drink everything.
Here, take this as well.
Thank you. Whew. Oh, it's so pungent.
As a dedicated alcoholic, this is right up my alley because it's super strong. It's like a lighter version of whiskey or like a yun. Strong cocktail, like 50-50, maybe 60-40.
Down it.
No, I cannot just down it. Are you insane? I'm gonna be so drunk. Do you think we need a nap before we go continue this?
No, this gets me fired up. Ready for some more puncha, Amelia?
Oh god, no, I'm done with the puncha. It makes me so sleepy.
This is, by the way, Coral, a Madeiran brewery. No superbok, no sakras here. Embrace the local specialities. You can definitely taste that it's a different kind of beer. It's more heavy, like a lager. I'm no beer expert, but delicious. It's beer. Beer is always good. It's like pizza. Anyways, we are at this place called Gavial. Novo. It's still in the old and charming town, and this is where we're gonna try some other Madeiran treats.
Hey, doggy.
Amelia, we're doing a food vlog.
It's too cute. We are starting out with ovas de espada, which is the eggs from the fish espada. The waiter told us that it's much better than caviar. I can see that it's fish eggs, but to me it's more like bacalao eggs.
It looks like meatballs, but when you get real close up with the macro, you can see that it's small eggs. It's so interesting how Madeira has a lot of its own dishes here. It's like you go to a whole new world, and let's morph into it.
Ooh, there's so much olive oil in the button. To me, it's nothing like caviar at all. So the lemon and the salsa and the olive oil makes it really, really delicious. I mean, I could definitely finish this dish myself.
I do think that a lot of Russian people would be offended if they found out that people said that this was better, because it's not. And I agree, it doesn't have anything to do with beluga. I feel like it could be really good, but it's like, it's a bit too dry. It's a bit sandpaper and dry.
In that case, let me eat it, because I love it.
You love it?
I really like it.
I like it, but I'm just saying, like, we can't make a food vlog here and then just say everything is amazing. We have to have a critic, like, we have to be like food critics, you know?
Filet de espada, a fish filet from the fish espada, which is caught right out here, and it's super traditional here on Madeira. This is one of the dishes that most of you guys, or most of our subscribers, has recommended us to try. And here you get it with a fried banana and some boiled vegetables. And also, we have to eat pretty fast because apparently today is Fatima's Day, a religious Christian event that happens once a year. And here in Funchal they have a special event where they walk the streets here, so all the table has to be removed. Therefore, I will try this really fast and tell you what I think.
Go, 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 go!
The fried banana first because it just smells amazing.
And what is the story about bananas here, because they are quite special?
They are smaller than the normal bananas and they are sweeter than the normal bananas. And also, they only grow here on this volcanic soil, so let's try.
Only on Madeira, Amelia?
Yeah, here!
Yeah, but there's volcanic soil in many
places. Can I
please
try my banana?
Okay, eat it, eat it.
Oh my god, this should be a dessert. They're so flavorsome. Oh my god, we honestly should move to Madeira. Like, the food is so good, but I would get even fatter here. You gotta try it. Yeah.
Wow. This is amazing. Oh. Oh my god. This banana here is super exotic and it's just, they have so much more taste than the ones we grew up with in Denmark, which was so boring.
And imported from the Netherlands, probably.
This is a highlight of today. No doubt about it. Number two is the lapas.
Lapa.
Oh my god, that was good too. Very good day so far.
I'm gonna consume for the rest of the week. It's basically the exact same thing that we had on top of our fish. Now it's just come with ice cream, so now it's a dessert. And Jon is having the famous passion fruit mousse. The passion fruit is from the island, and the island export a lot of passion fruits. That is one of the things that they earn a lot of money on. Oh my god, look at this.
Passion fruit is a passion of mine. Oh my god.
Mm. You like?
I usually prefer passion in alcoholic context, but this is pretty good as well. As the cherry on top, I got a puncher to finish off this amazing food tour of today. I think today has been wonderful, and Madeiran food is a lot more unique than I expected. Bye! Thank you for amazing food today.
It was a pleasure to have you in Ireland. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
This is the end of this food tour, and I am not only full, I'm also tired.
It's 12 o'clock, and we have a new day coming tomorrow with more adventures. We're going to stay in a tent on a cliff.
In the day tour.
It's going to be amazing.
I can't wait.
Thank you so much for watching.
Ati logo. Ciao, ciao.
Bye-bye.